Hi everyone, it's Angie the Craft NATO, and here we are on day two of our unbagging of my order, latest order from DP Clubs, and I've got four of them to show you today, so let's get into it. I reclaimed my scissors from the front room, so I won't have to struggle as hard to get into these guys as I have been. Make it a little easier on myself. Let's see what we've got for the first one. Looks like it's going to be a full drill diamond painting, and it looks like we're keeping with the theme. These should be about my last of the holiday themed diamond paintings that I'm going to be getting, because I know it's getting closer and closer, and we're running out of time as far as getting that holiday stuff delivered to us in time. I think there's probably still time at this point, but the deadline is growing near, put it that way. So I'm just going to roll this guy the other way so that we can get a better view of them. This canvas is a little on the stiffer side. It's not the stiffest I've ever felt, but it is a little on the stiffer side. So it is a 30 by 40 full drill, and it's just an old-fashioned looking Santa Claus with his sweeping coat. Looks like he's dancing with the stars. Not like the show Dancing with the Stars, but literally dancing with stars with a moon. I really liked this one because I liked the simplicity of the colors. I liked the fact that the Santa looked old-fashioned, and I liked that there was the stars and the moon in there. I thought that that was really cool because you guys know I'm into celestial things when it comes to diamond painting. So we've got 20 colors in this guy, and they're all letters in the legend, and the drill field does look nice and clear. Looks like there's a K but no X, so that's good. Sometimes when there's a K and an X, it can be a little difficult. But that looks all good. There is an A, but it's a different color from the K, so that's easy enough. So the drill field looks nice and clear. The canvas is sufficiently sticky, so that's also good to know. And let's take a look at the drills and see what colors we've got with this today. 20 colors, and it's a round drill. It does come with your standard toolkit, which every diamond painting will, to show or to give you everything you need to diamond paint, a pen, a plate of wax, and a boat. All right, let's see what we've got for drills. We'll start at the back end and work our way forward. So we've got white, of course. I wondered if there would be any white in this just because this looks like it's tinged so pink, the background there, but there is quite a bit of white, so that's good. Then we do have a couple of salmon-y pinks, an Elizabeth pink, a rosy pink, a baby pink, dark brown, chocolate brown, dark, dark blue, very pale pink, caramel brown, mustard yellow. So that's probably going to be our stars and moon because there's quite a bit of it. Goldish orange, Christmas red, love that Christmas red. Gray, couple colors of gray, another slightly darker red. Then we do have quite a bit of black, four bags of black, because all of the background is going to be in black. So you know we're going to have a lot of it. And they look to be pretty decent drills. I don't see any immediate problems with them just looking at them through the bag. You know, you never can tell until you go to actually put them on the canvas, but they look pretty good from here. Then we have a dusty rose and a purple, and those are the 20 colors. I wonder where that purple's gonna go. That's interesting. Probably part of the background with the around the stars, maybe, or around Santa. I'm really interested to know that. It's color number one. It's an R. Let's see. Yeah, it's around his border. So like bordering from going from the black to the Santa, there's gonna be some of that dark purple. That's going to work its way in there for shading. And it looks good when they do shading like that, when they don't just do a total color switch. They have a little bit of a little bit of a changeover. I think the diamond paintings look good when they do that. So that is the first one from this part of the order. And we'll get that put away and slide right into the second one. I hope you guys are all doing well today. I'm doing great. It's a bright, sunshiny day here in Michigan. Mild temperatures. We had quite a windstorm yesterday, but we didn't have any damage, luckily, in our immediate area. So that was good. I know a lot of the nation did experience some pretty strong winds and heavy storms. So I hope everybody out there is safe and well. Okay, the next one is another holiday-themed diamond painting. But it is not... It is very simple and very, you know, there's not a lot going on, which with a 30 by 40, it's kind of good to get diamond paintings where there isn't too much detail and too much going on. Otherwise, you run the risk of losing that detail in a smaller piece. But so this is absolutely perfect for this size of diamond painting. It's just some poinsettias with looks like some baby's breath or maybe just some holiday berries, white berries in some greenery. And I don't know, I wonder what color that background's going to be because it looks to like the background is going to be green too. So I hope that there's a good differentiation between the greenery that goes with the poinsettias and the greens that are going to go in the background. Looks like a lot of the background's W, which is 310. So you are going to have quite a bit of black background, but you are going to have some green background as well. So let's get into the drills. Well, first let's test the sticky. Very sticky. That one counts as a very sticky. It has 20 colors and the drill field is clear. And the key is made up of letters, all letters. So that makes it real easy for us when we're working on it. And I think this one is just like simply beautiful, just simple and very pretty. All right, let's take a look at these drills and see what we've got. See what our greens are gonna be. 20 colors worth of greens and reds because I can't imagine that there's gonna be anything else. But you never know. Sometimes they surprise us and they stick other colors in and you're like, huh, never would have thought. So we do have a large bag of black. So we do have a fair amount of black that's going to go into the background. It looks like it kind of goes across at an angle, kind of swishes across, the black does. And then the other two corners are made up of a combination of different drill colors we'll look at in a second. So then we have some Christmas red, some army green, some beige, two more reds. I'd say those are probably 606 and 666. So we're going to have a really pretty combination of those reds together. It's going to be very, very bright and bold. It's going to pop. Those poinsettias are just going to pop right off there. Very pretty. Then we have a Kelly green, a lime green, a very dark brown, a hunter green, two bags of hunter green. So I'm thinking that that's going to be our background too. Let's just take a look. Nine is a B, 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 B. Yes, so we have a lot of B in this background. So it's gonna be black in this hunter green, but then we've got H's and D's also. So we'll see what H's and D's are when we get there. So then we also have this purple. That's interesting. That's probably going to go into some background shading. Couple more greens, a very dark gray, chocolatey brown, milk chocolate brown, another dark green, a seafoam green, a sage green, two kind of salmon-y red colors, and another dark green. So it looks like these two dark greens and this dark green. So these three greens, which there's not that much difference between them. I mean, this one is definitely darker, but there's not much difference between these two. But these combined with black are going to be the primary background colors And then your foliage is going to be the lighter greens. So it looks like it is going to stand out nicely from the background. So that was the only thing I was a little bit concerned about when I saw it, is that there's so much green, you know, is it really going to show? But now that I see the drills and kind of look at the codes and line them up to the drills and really see, I can tell that it's definitely going to work out. So no more worries there. So that's a good thing. So we can mark that in the win column. That's a very pretty, very simple holiday diamond painting that you could leave up all through the winter months. Wouldn't have to take it down right after Christmas. I like those. Sometimes these are just easier to pull open than they are to cut. All right, let's see what we have next. Maybe it won't be Christmas, but it probably is. Not necessarily Christmas, but it is definitely winter. And oh my goodness, I love it, love it, love it. This is a 30 by 40 full drill round diamond painting. It says Home Sweet Home. And you've got just the black and white plaid decoration on the table with, you've got ice skates and snowman and a little potted pine tree, another little potted pine tree, some skis. It's just like a holiday centerpiece that they took a picture of and put it on, you know, the canvas. And you can tell there's like a window in the background. You can see the panes of the window. So this is kind of like setting on a table. I really like this. That's really pretty. I like this, the colors that are in it. It's, you know, going to be just probably grays and browns and black and white and green is going to be the only colors in there. There's 24 colors though, so obviously, you know, we're going to have varying shades of each. But the drill field is nice and clear. We have all letters for the legend, and it is very, very sticky. So that works out well. That is nice for us. And let me get this kink out right here and see if we can get it to lay a little bit more flat to look at. I'd say it's a moderately stiff canvas. It's not too stiff, but it's not, you know, really, really, not really, really pliable either, but it's not too bad. It's probably about a medium. That doesn't probably help too much, does it? Well, maybe a little bit. Still got a little bit of a crease there, but you get the gist of it. Now, there is a lot going on in this diamond painting for it being so small. But I think that it's so close up and it's just such the focal point that I'm thinking it's going to work. I'm kind of confident that it's going to work. So let's take a look at these drills. Now, these drills are in a little bit different packaging than what I'm used to, than most, I'd say. But these are the drill packages that have the white stripe. Always had good luck with these as well. So, ooh, just such pretty pale colors. I like all these pale colors. I really, really do. You guys know I do. Okay, so we have gray, army green, another army green, very light gray, dark green, another dark green, pink. That's a lot of pink. I wonder where all that pink goes. Let's see. Color number 14, which is J. I'm just going to go back here in the background. All through, smattered through the background. There's a little bit of multi-placing on here, but for the most part, it's pretty confetti-filled diamond painting. Another very pale gray. Kelly green. Sage green. A light cream. Probably I would say this is probably 3861 and 3860. You know, those colors are like a mauve color. Another pale gray, medium gray, dark gray, another gray, bluish gray, black, and some blue, country blue. And then we have two packs of white, a pack of cream, and, well, this looks like 3860 and 3861. Oh, you know what? 452 and 453 are those other two colors that look a lot like 3860 and 3861, just a little bit lighter. See how those, aren't they similar? They're just one pair is lighter than the other pair, but they're the same kind of hue. But they complement each other really well. This is going to look really nice. I really like this one. It's going to be very pretty. All right, let me roll these up and get them back in their container. And we'll get on to the next one and final one for today. Try to do that quickly for you, so if you're not sitting there waiting. This one feels lighter. We might finally have a partial drill kit here. I've been wondering where all my partials have been lately. It seems like all I've been ordering lately are full drill kits. I must have been in a full drill kind of mood. And nope, this is, oh, I believe that this is a duplicate of the one that I unboxed yesterday. I must have accidentally ordered it twice in this order. So I'm not going to go into a lot of detail about it because I did just talk about it yesterday. It's going to make this video a little bit short, so I apologize for that. But just in case you didn't see my video yesterday with my initial order from DP Clubs, this is a 30 by 30. It is a beautiful poinsettia with a background that has poinsettias in it, which I think is absolutely gorgeous. And you have this pretty patterned border on it. There are 24 colors, and I'll just show you the colors real quick, just in the interest of doing justice. All letters for the drill field. If you saw this one yesterday, you probably nice and sticky. So we'll just run through these drills real quick again, just in case you didn't watch yesterday. So we've got some greens, some dark navy blue, and some brick. Well, more of a pinkish brick than a true brick. Pink, lime green, red. That's more of a true brick color. Another green, cranberry red, dark hunter green, sage green, pretty orange. I wonder where that's going to go. Probably going to highlight that poinsettia. Very light gray, another tone of very light gray, Christmas red, cream, burgundy, red, gray, another orange, another dark green, a peach, and another cream. And those are the 24 colors that come with that. So I hope you liked today's little haul, and tune back in tomorrow and I will have the third and final part of this unbagging of my latest order from DP Clubs. Don't forget that I do have a discount code at DP Clubs. It's Angie15. You can get 15% off your order if you put in that code at checkout. I will link all of these in the description field of the video. And if you have any other questions, feel free to contact me in the comment section of the video. So with that, I will let you guys go. Thanks for watching and subscribing, and take care, and I will talk to you guys tomorrow. All right, thanks a lot. Bye, guys. But wait, I'm back. I'm not finished. I thought that it was really weird that I had ordered two of the same item, and I didn't. So this was the one from yesterday that I showed you. That was the 40 by 40. And they are quite different. This one is a 40 by 40. And it has the bird with the holiday balls and but the same kind of border. This one that I showed you today is a 30 by 30, has the same holly leaf background, but it has a poinsettia, but it does also have the same border, and it's only a 30 by 30. This one has 24 colors. This big 40 by 40 has 22 colors, and the colors are different as well. So I just wanted to point that out, that I didn't order the same thing twice in the same order, but I ordered two very similar things. So just as a comparison, you can see how they would look. And I think that you wouldn't have, I mean, I love this one, don't get me wrong, but a 40 by 40 is, you know, going to take quite a bit more time. And I think that in this 30 by 30 size, I think this is going to be just as beautiful. So if you're interested, you know, in that, but you maybe didn't want to do such a big size, this 30 by 30 might be perfect. So I just wanted to come back on and throw that in there, just so you would know that I'm not losing my mind. Not all of it, not yet. All right. Thanks a lot, guys. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.